Hello friends, welcome to this e-tutorial on student-centered methods of teaching mathematics. After watching this video, you will be able to explain student-centered methods of teaching mathematics, appreciate the different student-centered methods of teaching mathematics, apply them for promoting mathematical understanding among learners. In the rapid changing world, technology has brought unprecedented innovations in all the aspects of human civilization. To handle this technological world, knowledge in mathematics and science are very much mandatory. Throwing light on this truth, Dr. Abdul Kalam, 11th President of India, remarked in his speech that mathematics and science create the basis of the modern world. He stresses needed to disseminate globally on the ancient Indian theories containing scientific and mathematical knowledge for development. In line with Obama, ex-president of America, remarked in his speech that math and science provides the ability to understand our world and help to transform our economy as well as our lives for the betterment. From this, we can understand mathematics and science are mandatory subjects, not only important for individual attainment, but also important for the nation's development. So, every nation tries to produce a technically skilled person by improving their mathematical and scientific knowledge among its citizens. Criticism in teaching of mathematics. But one of the major criticisms on teaching learning mathematics is large number of failures or performance lags in the subject. Most of the students feel that concepts and procedures of mathematics are difficult to understand because rules and algorithm overlook them. This leads them to do more error when they solve mathematical problems, which create frustration in the minds of the learners and make them to drop out the course. As a consequence, students tend to lose the sense of importance of mathematics and move away from the quantitative literacy. There are many reasons identified for students' failure in mathematics. Among them, researchers focused in learning mathematics proved instruction or defective methods adopted by the teachers play a crucial role in handling the mathematical development among the students. What is going wrong in mathematics classroom? Many teachers' mathematical instructions focuses mainly on the procedural fluency, then conceptual understanding. So, students are not able to understand, recall the facts, use correct algorithms to solve a problem and apply them in the real life situations. Due to that, mathematical understanding cannot attain by the students. How to improve mathematical learning? To improve mathematics learning, mathematical instruction should focus on how to keep learners engaged using tasks and authentic activity situated in the real meaningful context, which facilitates practical and intellectual action through interactions by taking the account of students' ideas. To promote relational understanding and mathematical proficiency, student-centered methods of teaching mathematics should be adopted. What is student-centered methods? Student-centered methods of teaching mathematics are the combinations of different instructional methods and approaches, thus draws from multiple theories, disciplines and trends in the field of education. In student-centric classroom, students' ideas are key factors. Teachers begin their classes by understanding where the students are with the students' ideas. In student-centered methods, importance are given for learning by doing, learning by communicating, learning by experience, which means students take active part in the as equation of their own mathematical knowledge. In this method, students' current knowledge and ways of thinking, as well as ways in which those learning develop, are taken into account. In student-centered method, emphasis is more on discovering and understanding the students' likes, interests, and skills. It lays the basis for the research-oriented attitude of the students and conditions the development of skills in terms of putting forward and verifying the hypothesis concerning natural phenomena and process, practical application of knowledge, observation, measurement, and experiments, as well as broadening the knowledge of the methodology. In student-centered method, emphasis is on knowledge and skills associated with the traditional content areas as well as 21st century skills. Here, importance is given for instructional activities that actively engage students in sense making by building on their prior learning and connecting to personal experiences. Often it happens through collaborative group work. A learning environment characterized by trust and strong relationship between the teacher and the students. Student-centered methods can be applied in everyday situations in which students deal with their own task and project. In this strategy, mathematical thinking, reasoning, and competencies of learners play a crucial role. Here, focus is on the individual through differentiation, scaffolding, and opportunity for choice. Role of teacher in student-centered methods. In student-centered methods, teachers act as an active friend, guide, working partner, and careful observers. Teacher uses the students' idea to promote mathematical proficiency. They give chances to all the students to come forward and took active participation in mathematical tasks. Here, teachers listens to the students' conversations, what students are talking, thinking, and doing while performing the mathematical task. Teachers provides demographic atmosphere in classroom and personally involve the individual through actions and emotions in the educational situation. Now, let us discuss the different student-centered methods of teaching one by one. The first method is analytic method. Analysis means breaking up, unloose, or to separate things that are together. Thus, separation of different parts of problem ultimately gets connected with something obvious or already known. Analysis starts with what we have to find out and traces the connection between it and the data. Analytic method proceeds from unknown to known concepts. With the help of this method, the different parts of any problem can be analyzed to find out the solutions to the given problem. It is a scientific and formulation method. In this method, every step has its own importance and reasons, which leads to discovery and encourages a meaningful learning based on heuristic approach. In this method, there is enough opportunity for learners to present their original thoughts. Therefore, analytic method develops originality of thinking and reasoning among students. The students can recall and reconstruct easily if they forget any steps. These methods provide a close contact between the teacher and the taught. The next method let us discuss is inductive method. Induction means proving a universal truth or theorem by showing that if one rule applicable to a particular case and it is equally applicable to different similar cases. From this, we can understand that techniques of making transaction from particular facts to generalizations. About these facts are known as the process of induction. In inductive method, emphasis is given more on inductive reasoning. In this method, we proceed from particular to general. In this method, students are active listeners and discoverers of new knowledge, which provides opportunity for better meaningful learning. The knowledge attained by inductive methods becomes solid and durable, and different mental powers of the child can also be developed. This method has been found to be a very suitable method for teaching mathematics, because mathematical formulas and generalizations are the results of induction method. This method encourages better people-teacher relationship. The next method let us discuss is heuristic method. The term heuristic has been derived from the Greek word heurisko, which means I discover. This method is more important in mathematics learning because here students work like a researcher and solve the problem. It is a method in which the student discovers facts, informations, relationships and principles by themselves. It provides training in scientific method of inquiry and investigation skill among the learners. This method is based on the principles of learning by doing. It helps the students to get more exact, observant and thoughtful solutions. Heuristic method enables the students to listen, to observe, to ask and to discover. By use of this method, scientific reasoning and mathematical attitude can be developed in students. So, the knowledge obtained through this method is stable in the minds of the students. In heuristic method, students are trained to collect data, interpret data and arrive at the solutions by rejecting superfluous statements. If successful implementation of heuristic method can develop efficiency in problem solving skills, individual practical work, careful observation and independent thinking, which make the student self-reliant. The next method let us discuss is laboratory method. Laboratory method is quite competent to relate the theoretical knowledge with the practical base. This approach makes the learning process more interesting, lively and meaningful. In this method, students get the opportunity to acquaint themselves with the facts through direct experiences individually. Laboratory method is the experimental portion of the inductive method, or we can say the practical form of the heuristic method. This method proceeds from concrete to abstract. This method provides also opportunities for social interaction and cooperation among the students. It also encourages the habit of inquiry and investigation among the students. Laboratory method stimulates students to do experiments or encourages to carry out certain activities to make discoveries in order to verify the validity of mathematical generalizations, laws or a statement. This method is based on the psychological principles of learning, such as learning by doing, learning by observation and so on. A well-furnished mathematical laboratory helps in stimulating and worthwhile experiences, in clarifying the meanings of mathematical principles and for the acquisition of understanding of the skills. The success of the laboratory method depends on the skilled mathematics teacher as well as the availability of a well-equipped mathematics laboratory. The next method let us discuss is project method. Project method is the outcome of Dewey's philosophy of pragmatism. The exponents of this method contend that the knowledge turns into power only through application. Purposeful activity carried out in the natural environment is a significant feature of this method. In project method, the method is an ideal way of promoting creativity and including the spirit of inquiry among the students. Project method is based on the psychological principles of learning, such as learning by doing, learning by living, learning through association, cooperation, and activity. In project method, teaching and learning are considered from the child's point of view. Here, students select, plan, execute, and evaluate their project by themselves. The knowledge and the skills are learned by the pupils through practical handling of the problem in the natural setting. In project method, students carry out a variety of activities cooperatively. This method consists chiefly of building a comprehensive unit around an activity which may be carried out outside the classroom. The next method let us discuss is problem solving method. As the name indicates, problem solving method begins with the statement of the problems that challenge the students to find the solution. This method stimulates reflective and creative thinking of the students. In the process of solving the problem, students require to gather data, analyze and interpret the information to arrive the solutions to the given problem. This method develops analytical, critical and generalization abilities of the child. It is one which involves the use of process of problem solving or reflective thinking. The next method let us discuss is action teaching. Action teaching, rooted in Piaget's theory of cognitive development, applied mainly in teaching of mathematics. The overall aim of this method is to gain operational knowledge by a student through a well-planned set of teacher-students actions. Students construct their knowledge by integrating with materials various tasks through the prism of their experiences. The task shall be selected in such a way that enable the students transition from concrete operations through symbolic or abstract one. A thorough analysis of operation within the concept, which must be acquired by students, is the starting point of planning and selecting a task. To conclude the section, methods are the way to understand and practice the art of teaching. Method of teaching have an intimate relationship with teaching and instructional objectives. Any method can be effective method for teaching mathematics in the hands of an able and resourceful teacher of mathematics. Every method has some goodness in it. Children should be told as little as possible and induced to discover as much as possible. By using student-centered methods of teaching mathematics, teacher can provide successful experience, maintain the interest, and enhance the mathematical thinking proficiency among the students. With these words, I conclude my section. Hope you enjoyed the section. Let us meet again. Thank you.